YouTube, Edgar here, and welcome to Artifexian. Here you will learn everything you ever wanted to know about world building, and then some. An open letter to Elliptical Galaxies. Dear Elliptical Galaxies, why are you so incredibly boring? I mean, I've spent so long researching into you guys, trying to find something interesting to say about you, and to be honest, you've kind of let me down.
For shame, Elliptical Galaxies. For shame.
For starters, instead of having big, beautiful, colourful spiral arms, you instead look like a featureless monocolour blob hanging around the cosmos. You also contain very little gas and dust, so interesting things like star formation rarely occur, and what stars you do contain tend to be all very old, low-mass stars. Now, I hate to be ageist, but old, at least in the astrological sense, equates to boring. Like, imagine for a second that our Earth was suddenly transported into an elliptical galaxy. What would the sky look like?
Well, bland.
Stars would be uniformly distributed across the night sky. It would be almost featureless save for the abnormal amount of globular clusters. Ellipticals tend to have numerous globular clusters orbiting them, much more so than spiral galaxies. Even still, it is up for debate as to whether or not these clusters could be seen given the uniformity of the night sky. Call me a spiral chauvinist, but I like my night sky filled with varying stellar types, dust lanes, and a galactic disk arcing across the sky. Now, to be fair, there are some interesting things about you, but not enough to draw the attention of a world builder. But it's still worth noting that for one thing, when it comes to size, you are much more versatile than your spiral counterparts. And the actual physics keeping you stable is moderately interesting. I mean, it's nothing like Euler's identity kind of interesting, but frankly, I'll take whatever I can get at the moment. Firstly, the stars inside you tend to orbit radially, as opposed to in a single plane, which is cool, but really dangerous in terms of galactic habitability. Also, there is a tight correlation between the velocity dispersion of your stars and the size of the supermassive black hole. This is called the M-sigma relation. It's a little too complicated to get into right now. Go check out the link in the description if you're interested. Lastly, you ellipticals tend to be found near the center of galactic clusters or groups, and are thought to be the result of galactic collisions. Look, I'm as much a fan of massive extinction level events as the next guy is, especially those on the galactic level, but dear ellipticals, you are in every way possible the graveyards of the cosmos. Yours sincerely, Artifexian. Guys, find me on Facebook and Twitter, but more importantly, like and subscribe right here on YouTube. Thank you for watching. Edgar out.